Daytona Beach police have another ATM robbery on their hands.
It's the latest in a string of recent ATM robberies in the city.
A gunman threatened to shoot a 30-year-old at the money machine at a Wells Fargo on White Street early this morning. WESH 2's Claire Madds live at the bank. And Claire, do police believe the same suspects are responsible?
Well, who knows, Martha? Sometimes it's one suspect, sometimes it's two suspects. More often than not, their faces are covered, or the victim is so hysterical they're not really studying that because they're too busy looking at a gun pointed right at them.
Somebody pointing a gun at you, you got to be fearful.
Police have actually been doing undercover surveillance at area ATMs since the first robbery was reported in late May, but they can't be everywhere. And early today, a suspect, here's a still photo of him, though his face is covered, came up behind a victim as the 30-year-old was depositing a check. According to the report, the armed man said, "I don't want to shoot you, but I will if I have to."
He only had a couple of dollars, so he had to make a withdrawal of like $300 from the ATM machine and gave it to the blackmailer, and he ran and he fled the area.
Just last week, Marjorie Burns and Leonard Wilson were at a different ATM in the overnight hours when two armed men demanded they withdraw cash. Marjorie could hear a bullet being chambered.
All I could think about was, where's he going to shoot me? Am I going to die tonight? Am I going to see my kids? What's going to happen?
A woman making a night deposit for her business was robbed at an ATM 2 weeks ago. And this week, 22-year-old Rebecca Mattis was shot in the leg after being carjacked and forced to drive to her ATM.
I said, I can't die yet. I'm 22, I can't die yet. Today's not the day.
Here's an image of this morning's victim handing over the cash to the gunman. And fortunately, that was enough. The suspect took off. The victim was spared. But these days, using ATM machines can be dangerous business.
Nighttime, it gives the bad guy a little bit more opportunity to get away. You just have to, sometimes you just have to be cognizant of your surroundings.
And you know, we know people are not going to stop using ATMs, but if you can help not going at night, that's probably a good idea. If you do have to go at night, police say drive around the area first, scout it out, make sure you're the only person here using the ATM, or that you see perhaps a law enforcement officer, someone else in the area. And if you're making a business deposit regularly, change your routine. Reporting live in Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.